This has been a huge team effort from a lot of players, and there are not many places in the state of Alabama where you could get public safety from different jurisdictions and different agencies to work together like this. And this group, I just think we all ought to give everybody that's involved a hand, because of you know, I don't know of any other place in the state that this could have happened. Our public safety people worked together like no other, and we saw that on April 27th. They worked together like no other. So with that, I'd like to introduce Sheriff Dorning. The sheriff has boldly stepped up to be the person to test this system, and there's some reasons for that. One, he covers the entire jurisdiction, and he has a fewer units than most. He might have 15, 20 units out there at any given time, and he's only using two channels right now. We are waiting for some additional FCC licenses to come in so that we can get everybody else in the system. In the meantime, we needed a shakedown cruise. We needed somebody to come on and use the system for us. So, Sheriff, thank you for stepping up to that role.
Well, thank you. You really don't understand what today is. A lot of people don't really understand how monumental it is to have this type of a communication system, because, you know, we've never had one. Remember when I went worked for the sheriff's office almost 29 years ago, the radio that I had in my patrol car was an old tube type radio. In the wintertime, I would have to fold the back seat down to expose the trunk to get enough warmth in the trunk to be able to communicate, because the tubes, if they ever got cold, it would not transmit or receive. So we've came a long way. In the past couple of weeks, since we were the testing agency, we went from about 45% coverage in Madison County, which was a real life-threatening situation for our deputies in the field, to where now we're probably 90%, and we're using A units. And those are the handheld mobile units that we carry on our person. And the night that we issued and trained our men to use them, it was needed at the state line on Highway 231 when we had an officer that was attacked by an individual. So his emergency notification sent that out, and it worked perfectly, just like it was supposed to. And you know, we're just so excited. I've got a couple of people that I really, or a few people, we could not have been able to participate had it not been for our county commissioners. When we went to them and said it's gonna cost this amount of money, I said, we're going to have help, because our budget just cannot absorb the cost. And of course, a lot of people really need to understand that a large portion, or the infrastructure which actually makes it go, that cost was absorbed by the 911 center. And so that was a cost that we didn't have to have. And so just to put the mobile units and the A units for our men and women out in the field, and help to supply units to smaller agencies around in the county, I thought it was very important. And so it's a great day. Ernie, it's a success. I mean, really, we are so far from where we were. And when I said monumental, we have changed the means of communication for Madison County for many years to come. Because coming from where we were, it is absolutely just amazing. And I want to thank you, thank the board for the 911 center. Thank you so much.
Well, this has been an effort of herding cats. You've got different agencies, different jurisdictions, different functions, and we all pulled together and made it work. And again, this Radio Advisory Council is, they're the rubber, where the rubber hits the road to make it all work. But in the herding cats, there was a cat herder in chief that I want to introduce next. Early on, when Mayor Battle was elected, he and Mayor Finley and Mike Gillespie at the County Commission got together and buried the hatchet. And I believe that was the thing that made this all possible. I'd like to also recognize John Howell from Hemsey, who just came. Hey, John. But Mayor Battle, cat herder in chief. He helped in so many ways to get all of these different personalities together, these diverse people, and make it all work. So, Mayor Battle.
Thank you, Ernie. Ernie have been caught a lot of things. A cat herder is just not one of them. You know, today is an example, though, of intergovernmental cooperation. When we sat down at the table out here, it was the county commission, it was the city of Huntsville, the city of Madison, and we started including the other municipalities in the area. And this is a day where we cooperate with each other for something that's better for the community. It's for a system that now works, that everybody can hear, everybody can communicate with each other, and it's a good thing for our community. So Ernie, congratulations. Sheriff, I'm glad that you can now hear your guys and you don't have to use so much on your cell phone bill. But this is a great thing for our community, and thanks to each of you who have played an important part to make this happen in this community.
Ernie, I'd like to thank you, and I'd like to thank the 911 board. What we did is the Radio Advisory Council is we provided the end user input into the system and kind of went at it from that standpoint. We're all first responders. We don't have a lot of the technical knowledge that Susan has, Motorola has, or Ernie has. We just can tell you what it needs to do when we've got it in our hand and we're trying to use it, and make it perfectly clear to them that it has to work and it can't fail. And what we've come up with is we sat down at the big table and we hammered it out. And we have a system today that is, I say, the premier system in the state of Alabama. And that the state of Alabama, other agencies in the state of Alabama are gonna look to pattern their systems after our system. And we could not have done it if we did not have the complete and full support and commitment of Mayor Battle and the City Council, Mayor Finley, the City Council of Madison, and the County Commission, and Dr. Gradford as chair of the 911 board and the 911 board. So everybody here should be proud that there is a commitment to public safety in this county, and it's just outstanding that we have that here.
I would like to say on behalf of the Madison County Communications District Board of Commissioners, and I'm introducing a new term that we've been known as 911, but we are the Madison County Communications District, and with the featuring of this process today coming to fruition, I think we can live up to that capability. You know, in order to have communication, you have to have capacity in order to communicate. This is capacity to the nth degree, and I appreciate the opportunity to work with this commission and work with this community and work with the mayor and the of Madison County and City of Huntsville, along with the County Commission. We've had some tough times in the background, but every time we had a tough time, we were able to overcome that. Now, I would be remiss if I didn't mention Hal Potts, who handed the program off to me when he retired. Hal Potts has been a long-term servant with this particular area, and we appreciate what he has done, and he still attends meetings. He doesn't have a lot of anything but wisdom to give us, so we appreciate that. And everybody who worked on this project has been so helpful and so professional and so energetic in doing what it is we need to do. Making plans that went awry and only to come back with the plan two that came to fruition. And I told someone a while ago that nothing is better than seeing a plan come to fruition. Again, thank you, and we look forward to working with this plan and others in the future. Thank you.
And this is the construction of the last of three new, we built three towers from scratch. This is the third tower to go up. We've already gotten two up. and we're using two existing sites that are already in, one in Madison on Rainbow Mountain and one in Huntsville on Burritt Mountain. So this is the last site in its final construction. They just topped it out up there, and we're real excited about it. So if everything goes well, within a month, we'll be up and running with the entire system, and that will give us plenty of time to meet that January 1st, 2013 date to get everything tuned and adjusted and optimized so that we will have the kind of system that we need for our first responders. We got another event like the 2011 tornadoes here in Huntsville and Madison County. All of the agencies under the new system would be able to talk to each other. So if you're out on the scene, we could have common channels programmed into every radio so that any responder on the scene, be they sheriff or city of Madison or HMSI or county fire, if they're on the scene, they can go to particular channels to talk to who they need to. And so everybody would have the same platform so they could all talk to each other. And what it does is it makes things more efficient. Things don't get lost in translation, and it saves time. About 6 years ago, we started a lot of discussions with all of the police, fire, and ambulance agencies in Madison County, Huntsville and Madison, about radio systems. And every agency, for one reason or another, needed to replace their radio system. The city of Huntsville system was getting older, and the city of Madison was also on that system, but it's getting so old that you couldn't get parts for it or get people to fix it anymore. The other agencies in the county that weren't on the city of Huntsville system had VHF and UHF systems, and there's a federal government mandate that those systems be changed by January 1st, 2013. So that's this January coming up.